Passive and active transport.
The active and passive transports described in this lesson play important roles in homeostasis. Homeostasis is the process of maintaining conditions within normal ranges inside the cells and the organism as a whole, which is required for cells to function normally.
Passive transport represents the movement of molecules or ions under their concentration gradient from an area of higher to lower concentration. It doesn't require energy to occur, while in active transport, at least one molecule is being moved against a concentration gradient from an area of lower to higher concentration by the aid of energy. ATP is a common but not exclusive energy source, since other energy sources may also be employed. There are multiple forms of passive transport, including simple diffusion, osmosis, filtration, and facilitated diffusion. Simple diffusion is the movement of solute molecules in a solution or through semipermeable membrane along their concentration gradient. In a solution, simple diffusion occurs by the actions of hydrogen bonds formed between water molecules and solutes. Examples of molecules using this process include hydrophobic molecules such as oxygen and carbon dioxide, also small uncharged polar molecules such as urea. Fick's laws describe the factors affecting the rate of diffusion. These factors include concentration gradient, length of pathway, surface area. Rate of diffusion increases with larger gradient, short pathway, and greater surface area, while rate of diffusion decreases when these factors are reversed. Osmosis is a form of simple diffusion that involves the spontaneous movement of solvent molecules along its concentration gradient through a semipermeable membrane. Osmosis maintains the target pressure of a cell across the cell membrane and provides the primary means by which water is transported into and out of the cell. Filtration is a process of moving molecules through a cell membrane by the use of a pressure gradient from an area of higher pressure to an area of lower pressure. Filtration can be represented in capillary exchange. During capillary exchange, when blood first flows into a capillary at the arterial end, the blood pressure or hydrostatic pressure is greater than osmotic pressure. As a result, filtration occurs and glucose, amino acids, ions, and oxygen pass into the tissue fluid. As blood continues to flow toward the venous end, the hydrostatic pressure falls and osmotic pressure becomes dominant. As a result, resorption of tissue fluids takes place, together with cell metabolites such as carbon dioxide, ammonium ions, and certain secretions like hormones. Facilitated diffusion is a process of biological transport mediated by two distinct types of transport proteins, channel proteins and carrier proteins, which interact with particular solutes. When a region of high solute concentration is separated by a plasma membrane from a region of low solute concentration, there is a concentration gradient between two regions. If the solute molecules are highly charged, their charges may protect them crossing membrane by simple diffusion, so they require ion channels to facilitate their diffusion. While if the solute molecules are large, their size may prevent their diffusion, so they require carrier proteins to facilitate their diffusion. Factors affecting facilitated diffusion. First, concentration gradient across the membrane creates a potential energy which increases as the concentration difference increases, which results in faster diffusion. Second, saturation. Since the number of carrier proteins in the membrane is limited, once all the proteins are bound, they can no longer bind more molecules, and this is described as saturation point, at which the rate of diffusion doesn't increase and remains constant. Third, temperature. Carrier transport rates increase more rapidly with temperature. Last, selectivity. Generally, there is a reciprocal relationship between the transport rate and the selectivity of the transport process. Different types of active transport. Active transport is subdivided into primary active transport, secondary active transport, vesicle or bulk transport. Primary active transport uses the energy of ATP to transport molecules through transporter proteins across membranes. It can be represented by two examples, sodium-potassium ATPase pump and proton-potassium exchanger. Sodium-potassium ATPase pump is an antiport pump which, by the aid of ATP, moves 3 sodium ions out of the cell and 2 potassium ions into the cell with each cycle of action. This made the system electrogenic. These pumps are important in maintaining cellular osmotic pressure and helping in signal transmission across the nerve cells. Secondary active transport moves molecules through transporter proteins. Sodium-potassium pump provides the sodium ions required to set up the needed gradient for these secondary transporters to move molecules against their concentration gradients. Secondary active transport can be represented by two examples, sodium-calcium pump and sodium-glucose transporter. Sodium glucose linked transporter is a simple pump which allows glucose into the cell against its concentration gradient, not by directly using ATP, rather by inward sodium ion gradient maintained by sodium potassium ATPase pump. Vesicle transport. Some molecules are just too large to pass through the plasma membrane or to move through a transport protein, so cells use vesicles to move these macromolecules into or out of the cell. There are two types of vesicle transport, endocytosis and exocytosis. Both are active transport processes requiring energy. Endocytosis is a process by which cells take in substances by engulfing them in a vesicle. It occurs when a portion of the cell membrane folds in on itself, encircling extracellular molecules or microorganisms. The resulting vesicle breaks off and is transported within the cell, and finally expel its content. Exocytosis process involves transporting cellular molecules into vesicles to the cell membrane. These vesicles fuse with the membrane and finally expel their contents to outside the cell.
Thanks for your watching.